To find 10% of something, multiply by 0.1. To add 10% to something, multiply by 1.1. To deduct 10% from something, multiply by 0.9. And if you want to find out what's 70% of 20, all you need to do is eliminate and multiply. In this video, you'll learn why when you see percentages, you should think of fractions. The word percent comes from Latin and means per hundred. If you have a basket with 100 apples and take out the 7 rotten ones, that's 7 per 100. And if you instead want to estimate the rotten ones out of 300 apples, multiply 7 by 3, which is 21. Understanding percentages as part of 100 is good. Even better is seeing percentages as a fraction of 1, like part of one pile or a slice of a whole pizza. That's because 25% is a quarter of 1, 50% is half of 1, 100% is 1. Italians understood this centuries ago. They didn't have the percent symbol yet. Instead, they used a flipped version of it, which evolved from writing percento and looked a lot like a division sign, which made sense. When you see, for instance, 25%, picture part over whole, which is equivalent to a quarter, or 0.25. The decimal is what we are really after. Imagine you own a hotel with 100 rooms. In the low season, 50% of rooms are booked. In the high season, 95% are full. On New Year's Eve, all 100 rooms are reserved. Now business is booming and you want to increase capacity by 20%. Using decimals makes this easy. This is because 1 plus 0.2 of that 1 is 1.2. Again, 1 plus 0.2 is 1.2. To add 20% to something, you take your whole, multiply it by 1.2 and solve your equation, which in this case gives you 20 rooms on top. Now say you want to expand again, this time by 25%. So you take your 120 rooms and multiply them by 1.25 to add the part you want to increase it by. The result is 150, or 30 rooms on top of your whole. Now say there is a crisis, only half of your hotel is booked and you want to downsize by 40%. This works in exactly the same way. You take your whole and deduct 0.4, which gives you the figure you use to multiply your whole with. Or put differently, to deduct 40%, you take the whole, multiply it by 0.6 and solve your equation, which in this case leaves you with 90 rooms for your hotel and 60 you could turn into an office. That's really all there is to it. And if you ever forget how percentages work, flip the symbol back sideways. 10% is 10 over 100, which is 0.1. If you found this helpful, check out our other videos. Join us on YouTube or on patreon.com/sprouts. For more information, classroom exercises, or videos without background music, visit sproutschools.com. Published under Creative Commons.